Seems this world. Hello, everybody. What's up? Welcome to the show. This is Tom McCaffrey. How's it going? Rate and review this podcast and subscribe and do all that stuff and like it and stuff like that and everything and stuff like that. Okay, so I'm back to talk about the today's episode of the Johnny Depp trial. Today was a really good episode, very funny, but probably the funniest so far. A lot of stuff happened. It was getting a little boring because, you know, Amber Heard was done testifying, so it wasn't as exciting. There were a lot of unknown names. But they had this guy on who was a clinical psychiatrist or something who was I couldn't even figure out what he was there as an expert witness to testify basically that Johnny Depp was a narcissist. That's basically this trial just gets more and more fucking ridiculous every day. the first week they brought in an expert to testify that Amber Heard was a bitch. I'm sorry, I'm left, but it's just like, it's just literally the most childish fight ever. It's just literally like, you know, I'm going to sue you in front of the world. You know, oh, who's your first witness? I have an expert who's going to come in and tell you she was a fucking cunt. Like, okay. What about your witness? I'm going to have someone come in and testify that he's a total fucking douchebag, narcissist. He's obsessed with stuff. They literally had an expert come in and testify that Johnny Depp was a narcissist. Basically, they had a 3.5 hour testimony of someone saying Johnny Depp was an asshole in his professional opinion. And they're like, how do you know he's a narcissist? He's like, well, you know, I watched things and I looked at him and, you know, it's like, what do you mean I know he's a narcissist? Look at his fucking life. His whole life is like on the cover of magazines and just, you know, his hair is perfect and he's always posing and he's been living this rock star life right there. Of course he's a fucking narcissist. You needed to bring in an expert to tell you this. It's like if you had a trial and you were like, you brought an expert to say that Kevin Spacey was creepy. You know what I mean? Like, welcome to the Kevin Spacey trial. Our first witness is going to testify. He's an expert. He's going to say he's a really weird, fucking creepy guy. So anyway, sorry, I'm laughing. I just thought that was so fucking funny. And so this guy came in and first of all, I think he's one of Amber Heard's biggest witnesses and he's fucking insane. He just looks crazy and like he didn't even comb his hair, like his hair's fucked up. It's like they're not even trying. And before I get into that, it's just the Johnny Depp's lawyers are like these amazing lawyers. They don't let the other lawyer ever say anything ever. That's like their tactic and it's working so well. It's like watching Amber Heard's lawyer try to ask questions is like such a painful experience because like apparently she does not know how to ask questions legally in court because they object to every single thing she says and she like, and they always sustain it. The judge is always like sustain. And then she'll argue. She'll be like, no, she's allowed to say it. And the judge is like, no, she's not allowed to say that. It's like every time. Like, it'll be like, so can you tell me what your name, objection, hearsay? It's just like, I mean, and then the judge is always like, sustain. It's like, really? Sustain? Like, that sounded like a nothing question. They have like four go-to. It's objection, hearsay, objection, speculation, objection, non-responsive, leading. Every single line. And so anyway, I just wonder what. So anyway, that's fucking working. I wish you could just do that in life. You could just object whatever it's like the way a question is going that you don't like. Like, You come home to your girlfriend's place, like, hey, so where were you all last night? Objection leading. Objection. Well, I thought maybe you were at your ex-girlfriend's house. Objection, speculation, hearsay. Someone said you were fucking her. Hearsay, objection. I'd like to strike that from the record. I wish you could do, they always do that in court too, which I love when someone says something that's like really incriminating. There's strike that from the record. And then they tell the jury, they're like, disregard what they said. Like, they're just going to forget that. Like, someone will accidentally, not in this case, but someone will accidentally be like, yeah, so and so told me they murdered them. Hey, strike that from the record. Disregard the word. All right, yeah, I'll forget that someone just admitted to the murder in court. I wish you could do that in real life. You know, again, your girlfriend, like, walks in on you having sex with her friend. Hey, what are you doing? Fucking my friend. Objection. Strike that from the record. Disregard what you just saw. You don't get to use that from here on out. Oh, okay. You can't factor that in into being mad at me. So I'm going to play a little bit of the guy. I just can't get over how his hair's not even combed. Like, this is the big, this guy knows he's going to be on TV. He knows he's going to be on TV, and he doesn't even fucking comb his hair. So they do such a good job on a cross, like making him look insane. Let me.
What do you use as a baseline? A baseline for.
He's asking, how did you measure Johnny Depp's cognitive abilities or something, like that he was able to function cognitively? And he goes, here he goes.
Processing speed? Yeah, for analyzing Mr. Depp before you watched his deposition. What is the baseline for that?
Yeah.
I mean, I guess my baseline would probably be how I've seen him interact in public. How I've seen him interact with others. I've seen him interact in media. I've seen him interact all, and his pro
What is your medical evaluation of him being a narcissist? I saw him in public. I'm sorry, just that. This is literally a witness they brought up. So, yeah, to my opinion, this guy's a narcissist. What did you base that on? Any medical assessment? What did you base that on? Medical? Well, I saw him on TV. He looked like he was really into himself. So.
The speed is certainly not slow. I've seen.
He literally said that like it was a real answer to give.
Do commercials. Is it process speed?
I saw him in a commercial and he looked really into
It's
himself.
not slow.
I'm sorry, I'm
Deposition,
laughing.
didn't you say that what you did was compare
I'm
with
sorry, just this is like this show, it's like it's gone from like being like the greatest drama, like romance, and now it's like the funniest thing show I've ever
Mr.
seen.
Depp's performance in lots of
This guy's name's Dr. Spiegel. This guy needs his own fucking show
pirate
immediately.
movies against his deposition testimony here.
What I said was I've seen Mr. Depp do apology ads. I remember he did apology ad with Bad Dog with no delay in process speed. I've seen him interact.
He's basically saying, didn't you base his your evaluation of his testimony on pirate movies?
With the media regarding to that, I saw no delay in processing speed. All I'm saying
Let
to you
me
is.
ask you about pirates, though. You compared pirates to the to the depositions given in
And
this
I
case.
apologize for what I said. And I misspoke.
You misspoke? You didn't make the comparison?
Right now, just a second ago? Just a second ago, I may have said that I misspoke. I apologize. I misspoke.
Okay. Because you know you can't compare pirates to sworn testimony, right?
Yes.
Love that the lawyer just slips that in. Yeah, because you know you can't compare legal testimony to pirates. First of all, this is how bad Amber Heard's lawyers are. They don't object to that. Like that is like 101 in objecting. That guy's basically making snarky comments about you being a fucking moron. Like they're winning, and the other side, Amber Heard's side, is just like, we don't even know. We've just like given up. So He does a really good job of making this guy look crazy.
Whereas right now, you're judging mine. We all judge processing speed as a baseline because of what we know about each other. I would say.
And then he comes out, he makes it, he goes like, you're making your evaluation on movie performances like something about like a jock factor. So you can't, you're not going to use Willy Wonka as a factor.
Speed right now is not slow. So, I mean, we're judging processing speed. I'm just saying to you.
Yeah. Any of Mr. Depp's other portrayals in movies, did that affect your analysis of processing speed?
Only I've seen him interact on interviews, and that was it. Right. When he wasn't in movies.
What, right. But Willy Wonka doesn't matter to you? You see him in that movie, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory? Did you look at that one when you were comparing his processing speed?
I mean, what are they doing? They're not objecting to this. They're just letting him go off to like a comedy skit. This literally turned into like a comedy bit. And he's like making faces.
Do I have to answer that question, Your Honor?
You have to answer questions. Yes, sir.
No, you'll be happy to know I didn't see Willy Wonka.
You'll be happy to... I cannot believe Amber Heard's lawyer did not jump in. Even the guy who's an idiot, the witness, looks at the judge and is like, am I really supposed to answer this question? This guy just asked me the most sarcastic asshole question in the world. Like, the lawyer literally asked a medical expert, did you factor in Willy Wonka in your analysis? I'm sorry, I don't think I can get through this. I'm gonna have to do a two-parter. This is just like there's I have like 10 things to go through. I don't think I'm gonna get past this first 5 minutes. It's like he's basically like going through like the characters he played, you know, like for his expert, you know, testimony evaluation of being an asshole, being a narcissist. He's like, I looked at a lot of things to do my assessment of his cognitive deficiency. I saw, you know, in a lot of characters he played, he has a lot of cognitive difficulties. Like, for instance, he's in one show I saw, he's always lying about his age. And he's pretending that he's in high school, and he's going into high schools and pretending he's in high school still. That was one, that looked like a problem, like he was losing his mind. He also seems to have an identity issue because he uses a lot of different names in the movies I saw. He seems like a jerk from those pirate movies. Also, I got the feeling he didn't brush his teeth a lot from the pirate movies. And apparently, also, I saw this one movie, and apparently he's a real crybaby. That's one thing. That was one of my notes that I took. Also, he can't sleep. That's really bad nightmares. Another assessment I made is that he gets murdered in his bed a lot. If you don't know, it's from Nightmare on Elm Street. He gets killed in the bed. And then there's a part where he's like, did you call Johnny Depp an idiot in your assessment?
You know that actors actually rehearse for their parts and work on the...
This is the best part. So he's like... So in the movie, he looked like he wasn't able to speak that well. He's basically like explaining how movies are. He's basically like, do you understand that when people are in movies and they act in movies, that they're rehearsing and trying to act a certain way?
100%. But with respect to acting, you know that actors actually, Mr. Depp, that's correct, isn't it?
All right, it's coming.
You made a very kind admission, I think, early on in your deposition, that you're not claiming to be a better actor than Mr. Depp. That's correct.
That's literally, like, no objection there. Literally, they just said that you basically made an admission that you're not as good an actor as Mr. Depp. They're acting so condescending, like he was being so polite. You made a very kind admission by saying that Johnny Depp is a better actor than you.
Isn't it?
Johnny Depp's trying to act normal in this whole situation. Is this guy really saying to this insane witness that he's admitting I'm a better actor than him?
But with respect to acting, you know that actors actually rehearse for their parts and work on the language, diction, timing of their dialogue as part of that rehearsal?
If you say that, I'm not an actor, so I don't know what goes on. I can't.
Do you know that actors, when they're in movies, that they rehearse and they memorize? So I say, look, I'm not an actor. I don't know anything about that stuff. What? I'm not a fucking scientist. It's like he's asking about like brain surgery. Like, you know, like when you do brain surgery, like I'm not a brain surgeon. Like you have to know anything about acting. Look, I'm not an actor. I don't know how those magical things are made. I have no idea that the shiny pictures. That would be a good answer if it was like, you know, 1920 and the first movie ever has just been come out.
I have no idea what goes on in acting.
Okay, but you don't know enough about acting to know whether actors rehearse?
Sir, I am not an expert in acting. I have no idea what an actor does.
Okay.
Again, they just fucking, Amherst lawyer just lets them say, you don't know enough about acting to know that actors rehearse. Okay, then there's a line, I don't know if they get, if it's going to, he says something about Marlon Brando. He's like, you made an assessment about Johnny Depp because you heard he wore an earpiece and they fed him his lines. And he's like, yeah, I heard that he did that. And they're like, but you don't know that that really is true. And he's like, well, no, I heard about it. And they're like, well, do you know actors do that regularly? And he's like, I don't know about acting. I don't know anything about acting. And that one I could understand he wouldn't know. But literally with the last questioning that, it was basically like, do you know about shooting, being in a movie? Like, I don't know about acting. Yeah, but you know that people appear in movies. Anyway, he says something like, did you know that Marlon Brando used an earpiece when he did movies, and the guy goes, really surprised, goes, Marlon Brando's dead. The guy's like, I was referring to like in the past tense, like, you know, when he was alive, he like used an earpiece. It's just kind of like, that was like the icing on the cake. I think that was the last question they asked. I think they were just like, there's no more we can do with this. This is just like, this is literally shooting fish in a barrel. You're gonna, like, this guy literally, I asked a question about Marlon Brando and he literally just said, Marlon Brando's dead. That was his answer. They're literally laughing. Oh God. So anyway, that was that. And then I guess I'll talk about it later, but I guess so Kate Moss is coming on Wednesday. I'm so pissed. I think it's ending on Friday. This is bullshit. I'm like really mad. I hope this thing gets picked up. But they had another woman on later, and this is just, again, how ridiculous this trial is. It's like she was like an agent or something, and they were literally going through. I think this kind of looked bad on Johnny Depp's side because the lawyers were just basically going through Amber Heard's career, compare it to other people's careers, and basically kept saying how shitty Amber Heard's career, basically kind of making the argument that Amber Heard didn't really, you know, suffer as big a loss from her, I don't know, if from her career fallout or something like that. Like, because I think they're speculating that she would have made, like, she would have demanded like $50 million salaries from, you know, so they want that as damages, like future damages. And they're kind of trying to prove like that, like she didn't have like that great a career, but it's like, it's really kind of demeaning because they're just kind of like, so she was in this movie, right? And you compared her to like Wonder Woman, and she's like, yeah, because that Gal Gadot was in Wonder Woman. She's like, well, you know, she was in Aquaman, Amber Heard. She's like, yes, but Gal Gadot was Wonder Woman. Like, she's not playing Aquaman, isn't it Aquaman? You know, and like, she's just kind of there. And then like, and all she was just on some TV. It's really funny. They go through her career and I'm kind of like, wow, she really didn't have that great a career. And I really think, she really owes kind of everything to Johnny Depp. Because, I mean, you know, I didn't really know. I definitely did not know she was before Johnny did this whole Johnny Depp thing. Like, years ago, I knew Johnny Depp was, like, married to her. But I didn't know who she was. This is really kind of a scary thing. Because Johnny Depp had this charmed, great life. And I know he had problems. But, I mean, it just shows you, man. If you pick the wrong person to be with, I mean, they could just fucking, you know, be... It's that old adage of, like, you know, you have to be careful about who you surround yourself with. And that's really true. Cause, like, I've seen it happen to people I know, not to this extent, but, like, you know, Will Smith, it's just amazing. They pick these chicks that just kind of, like, ruin them. They drag them down and they're just not aware of it. They kind of get caught up in, like, it's like they get kind of played from the outside. It looks like that. So anyway, and then another thing they do. So they went back and forth. I think they're going to go back with that agent again. But they were really kind of like on cross. They were trying to demean her. I mean, it doesn't come off nearly as bad as this guy. Because, like, okay, so I found the part where he talks about Marlon Brando. And it is, like, now he's like drinking Gatorade. He just looks like dehydrated and like, I just can't get over the hair. Like, no one on his team, on the Amber Heard side, was just like, dude, what are you, like, put some gel in your head. This is like, you're literally on the biggest thing in the world right now. So here it is about the Marlon Brando.
Guess what I said? I just said, I find it hard to believe. I didn't say it. I said, I find it hard to believe. That's all I said.
Yeah, but what you found hard to believe, sir, was that every line of the script was pumped through an earpiece. Where did you ever get the idea that ever that occurred?
That's what I read, and they got court review. The court.
He's basically saying that he heard that Johnny Depp had an entire movie set through an earpiece. Because where did you base that on? Where did you? He goes, I read it somewhere.
That's where I got it from.
And you know whether Marlon Brando used an earpiece?
Whether isn't he dead?
Yeah.
So the answer is no, he does not use one now.
That's like really, that's really his answer. He's giving as a serious answer. Do you know if Marlon Brando used an earpiece? Isn't he dead? Yeah. Well, then, no, he does not use an earpiece. No, you can't use it. Why would you use an earpiece when you're dead?
Oh, I used the past tense.
Oh, I'm sorry. I know nothing.
He says, I'm sorry. Like it wasn't a joke answer. That was his real answer, that Marlon Brando doesn't use an earpiece because he's dead.
Isn't he dead?
Yeah.
So the answer is no, he does not use one now.
Oh, no. I used the past tense.
Oh, I'm sorry. I know nothing. I will concede to you, I know nothing about acting. I will concede to you 100%. If that is the standard and people are done with acting, then I apologize and that was wrong on my part. If that's the standard, I'm wrong. I don't know.
Okay.
It must be like super intimidating. First of all, just being on the stand, knowing all these people are watching, and literally Johnny Depp is like staring at you from like 4 feet away. Like, how fucking weird would that be? Imagine you're just some normal person and like one day they're like, hey, we need you to testify in this trial, like when you were at the worked at the hotel, and they're like, all right, and then you show up and it's just like the camera goes everywhere, Johnny Depp is sitting across from you at a table, and like, and you're like have to do like 3 hours of answering questions. It's like, I mean, I guarantee you this guy's like a huge Johnny Depp fan. And he has to like have Johnny Depp laugh at him and stare at him. Isn't he dead? Yes, he's dead. Do you think he uses an earpiece? No, he's dead.
Let's go with that. No further questions.
All right.
That's when he stops. He's like, let's go with that. Almost like he's a director. Like, all right, cut and print. All right. I gotta go because I'm tiring myself out. All right, so like I said, subscribe tomorrow. I'm gonna have more stuff about this, and thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.